Hello and welcome to Modern Goddess Talk, where we expand our self-worth and net worth so we can shine our brilliance into the world. I'm your host, Dr. Marina Kostina, and today I have a brilliant woman, a woman who wears many hats, Traci S. Campbell. She's a socialpreneur, a public speaker, an author, TV and radio host, an IT professional, and a founder of two amazing organizations. Traci, welcome to our show.
Thank you for having me. This is exciting. I'm glad to be here.
Yes. And you know, with all of the list that I have, okay.
The laundry list.
Yes. All of the roles that you serve in this life, what is your number one favorite role? Do you have one?
Oh, wow. My number one favorite role. Well, it would probably have to be that of wife. And I have a great husband who's highly supportive of what we do. He's an integral part of the team. So I would have to say that would probably be my first, my role that I love the most, let's say it that way. But then very close behind that is basically being the person that you described under one umbrella, and it's called social entrepreneurship, and being able to develop programs and initiatives that truly help shape lives, make a true difference in communities. And yes, there is a for-profit component to some of it, but the mission underneath is really to make a difference in the community.
And you're great at that. You know, one of your organizations, the abbreviation is CHAMP, I love it. Okay, and you work with helping parents and teens on, educating them, right? Helping them with their emotions.
Exactly.
What is this about? Can you just tell us about it?
Sure.
What you do exactly, and why did you come up with this idea?
Absolutely. Well, I am the product of a single parent home. And my mother and I struggled quite a bit, and it definitely wasn't easy. And we were a team, we were partners. And there were things that she did well, there were things that she struggled with. And so fast forward several years later, I lost her in 2007 to heart disease. And after that, I thought, wow, you know, I really want to do something that's going to help other families, single parent families, similar to what I grew up in, to deal with their emotions, to deal with all the emotional garbage that single parent homes face, the challenges that they face, which are really unique to a single parent home. And hence CHAMP. CHAMP stands for character, happiness, attitude, mentality, and purpose. And I'm a firm believer, Marina, that if any of those traits are missing as someone is coming up, as someone is maturing, if any of those traits are missing, they're going to struggle. They're going to struggle mentally. They're going to struggle emotionally. It's going to affect their job, their career, their relationships.
Absolutely. And you know what? It's almost like, you know, the Maslow's pyramid of needs, right? We do need to have, of course, basic needs, but we also need to feel happy and satisfied in life in order to be. And it really scares me that the schools don't teach us this.
No, they don't.
So you really filled the void of the school education with your program.
Absolutely. Well, that's the goal. The goal is to provide what I like to call supplemental emotional education. Okay. We want to fill that void, if you will. We want to make sure that while this young person is getting good grades in reading and math and science, all that's wonderful, but if we send them out into the world and they are not equipped mentally and emotionally to deal with challenges, if they're not able to really reconcile where they are in their family, maybe it is a single parent home, maybe it's not a great scene, it's not a good environment, that's okay. We can get them past that, but they have to be strong enough to deal with those issues.
Absolutely. It's interesting that you talk about successful life of teens, and you know, you are an example of a successful entrepreneur, and you know, we people are very funny. You know, when we watch somebody successful, we only concentrate on that, and we don't really think how hard somebody worked or how long the journey
was.
I know your journey was not easy.
No, it wasn't.
Were there any pivotal kind of moments, the defining moments for you when you, what made you what you are today?
Absolutely. Well, it definitely was. There were many, but the one that truly launched me onto what I like to call my real passion was the loss of my mother in 2007. I went from being a daughter to being a caregiver to now what, you know, when she transitioned in 2007. So at that point, I had a very successful career in IT and traveled quite a bit, and all of that sounds great, but it wasn't my true passion. It was something I was good at. It was something that allowed us to change our whole lifestyle, but it wasn't a passion. It wasn't something that I was excited every morning when I jumped out of bed. So fast forward to taking that loss and transitioning that into a true passion, which is where Champ came from. And then fast forward a couple years later, we have BIBO, Beauty In, Beauty Out. So that was a pivotal moment for me, is, you know, turning that loss into a whole other path in my life, and hopefully being able to benefit many others.
Well, talking about this other organization of yours, BIBO, right? Could you please, I love that so much, because, you know, my approach is about rhinestone mentality and diamond mentality,
which
really resonates with Beauty In and Beauty Out, right? All of this concept. So can you tell us a little bit more about the award? What is beauty for you? Mm-hmm. How do you choose your nominees? And what does it really mean for you to be a successful woman that needs to be celebrated, that you want to celebrate in your BIBO Foundation?
Absolutely. Well, you know, this whole notion of beauty, we're in such a narcissistic society. I mean, unfortunately, our young people, especially our young women, are inundated with pressures to be a certain size, to look a certain way, to wear their hair a certain way, and it's just getting worse and worse. And so when we talk about beauty, at least to me, beauty is very subjective. It's not just about genetics, even though that's pretty much what it's regulated to. It's always, you know, we always focus on the genetics of a person and whether or not we deem them aesthetically beautiful. Well, that's the easy part. That's something that you were born with. What I think true beauty is the whole person. Beauty needs to be looked at holistically. What do you do? What do you stand for? How do you give back to others? What difference are you making in the world? What is your individual style, so to speak, and not just clothes, but your way of doing things? That, to me, makes a person truly beautiful. You can be aesthetically attractive and physically attractive, but that's genetics. That's something that you were given. You didn't have to work for it. I think it's really beautiful when we can celebrate someone who had to work to achieve all those other things.
And they are the most attractive people. When
yes,
people
they are.
Do what they love, it is just...
They radiate.
Absolutely.
They absolutely do.
They do. That is so amazing. Thank you so much. Well, what are some practices mm-hmm. that you use, and maybe if you have a life motto mm-hmm. that helps you keep your beauty, okay, your inner beauty, to bring it out and
absolutely.
To keep you strong, because we need to feed ourselves first in order to share with others.
Yes, you know, I'm a firm believer in the old adage that everything is temporary and that everything has a season. And the reason why those resonate with me is because when you're going through something, whether it's a loss or a transition, you're fighting some fight mentally, emotionally, whatever it is, we always feel that when we're in the midst of it, that it's never going to change and that we're stuck here and that, you know, the world's going to end. We all feel that because we're all flesh and bone. But that's far from the truth. The truth is that everything that we do, every minute that ticks by, is temporary. And if we keep that in the forefront, it helps us to deal with life's challenges. If we're able to keep that that truth in the forefront. For me personally, I am a Christian by faith. Prayer and praise and worship is something I practice on a regular basis. So for me, that helps me stay grounded, and it gives me the strength physically and mentally, but also the wisdom and insight in order to make the decisions that I make. And everyone has their own spiritual path. Whatever that is for a person, I strongly encourage them to follow that, because that will keep them grounded.
Wow, you're an amazing, fascinating, and a beautiful woman, and an entrepreneur, and just a human being. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Can you please share how the audience can find you?
Absolutely. Well, it's really, really easy. You can go to www.bibowards.com, and you can get plugged into our annual award show, which is absolutely amazing. We're honoring incredible women like Dr. Marina Kostina this year in 2017. You can also go to our foundation site, which is www.thebibofoundation.org, and you can go there and find out about all of our initiatives and the things that we do, and of course champcommunityproject.org to find out what we do for at-risk teens and single parents.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And thank you for being with us, and make sure that you really look for the beauty inside so you can shine your light outside. Happy vibes, happy lives.
We'll be right back.